Good morning, KTA. Happy Thursday, everybody. It is Thursday, October 1st. Happy October. Can you believe we are in a new month? Well, that is exciting because the weather's getting nicer and we're getting into fall, so that's always a fun season. And friends, as you know, it is fall break next week. I know you know that. You would not have forgotten that. And there's no school for students tomorrow, which is Friday, October 2nd. And then we have all of next week off, which is great, and I hope you have great times with your family and friends. And then we return to school on Tuesday, October 13th. And I want to just make sure everybody understands how to drop off and how to pick up when we are all back on campus on October 13th. So we have two drop-off locations and two pickup locations. In the morning, if you are just in third grade through eighth grade, you can drop off on the metro side and come in the J door, which is right near the art room. So again, third grade through eighth grade only, come on the metro side, drop off at the J door, and then you can come right in school, you can pick up breakfast, and you go right to your classroom. That's for middle school students as well who are coming on campus, because you will go through the school and then over to building 200. If you are kindergarten through second grade, you get dropped off in the front of the school by the office on the Galveston side. Again, that is kindergarten through second grade, and you go right in the A door, pick up breakfast, and go to your classroom. Now, if you are a family who has a student in third grade through eighth grade, and also a kindergartner through second grade, you can drop off at the A door also, because that's closer for the younger grades. So, does that make sense, everybody? And that same is in effect for pickup in the afternoon. If you are just third grade through fifth grade and eighth grade as well, you come to the metro side, pick up for K through two is in the front of the school. And again, if you have a family that has kindergartner and let's say a fourth grader, you come to the front of the school as well. So I hope that makes sense. And we are so excited to have so many friends coming back to us. And all grade levels will be in school. Teachers are very excitedly getting ready for all of that. So we will see you on October 13th.
Good morning, boys and girls. Today is a very exciting day for sixth graders who are in person. So sixth graders had orientation today, and they are on campus. And it's the first time, really, our middle school building has had students in it since March. So that is really exciting to see boys and girls back on campus. So today is orientation for sixth grade, and like Dr. Lesher said, tomorrow there is no school for anyone. So right now we have K through six on campus. Those are the people who are coming back in person. You will continue to come back in person after fall break. And then we get to have our seventh and eighth graders join on October 13th. Please remember, boys and girls, we need to go back to our uniforms. So today's a spirit day, but on Tuesday, after fall break, you will have Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday in your uniforms, and Ms. Snediger will share some things about uniforms because we have to get back in the habit because we've been gone a long time. And then Friday are always our spirit days, okay? So I hope you have a wonderful fall break. Please stay tuned. Ms. Snediger is going to talk to you about uniforms and a couple of other announcements.
Hey, Tigers. So we thought it'd be a good idea to just review our uniform and a couple elements of our dress code since we're all gonna be back on campus after break. So exciting. It's so nice to see all of your faces again, in real life. So, just a reminder that uniform at KTA, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, those 4 days, is a red, white, or blue polo top. And jeans are only allowed on Fridays. On the bottom, you can wear khakis, you can wear black or navy blue pants, but not jeans. You have to make sure that any pants you wear, jeans are allowed on Friday, but there are no rips. No rips or tears or anything like that. That's our dress code. And your shoes have to have a back to the shoe. They can't be like a flip-flop or something that has nothing on the back. All of our hair needs to be a natural color. That's another piece. And I think that's all that we're gonna say for now about dress code, but we'll be continuing to talk about it to make sure that we're all coming to school ready for a professional environment. So So I want you guys to stay on for birthdays and Tiger pledges, and have a great day. Have a great break.
A KTA student is a responsible citizen who is respectful, cooperative, courteous, and kind to others. At KTA, we are citizen scholars and friends. Go Tigers!
As a KTA middle school student, I am respectful, responsible, and resourceful. I will be conscientious and motivated member of the society. I will persevere through any challenge. As a KTA community, we are compassionate and